And some more steps to another part of the palace. Of course, don't forget, they were smaller in those days. Their feet weren't so long. Amazing. I'm loving every minute of this. The palace that was built and designed by David the First, following on from his parents, Malcolm the Third and Margaret. It's absolutely amazing. Here we've got lots of work done by the masons. No wonder they had a special group of them called the masons in the end, because of their enormous skills. This is a dark place to which to have carved out stuff though, isn't it? Original cobbled stone, look. Oh, there's a big slab. Huge, that one, isn't it? So this is still the palace. About it all. I can't get enough of it on video. I'm going to run out of video when I get in the church. Oh, there's so much to see. This could have been a toilet area, couldn't it? Dormitory. None of the monastic buildings which were presumably built along with the church in the 12th century have survived at Dunfermline. The remaining fragment of the dormitory range on the east side of the cloister is the earliest of those which do survive. It probably dates from the late 13th century. We've got their little rows of beds in here then. Now this could have been, there could have been flooring on there maybe. Not quite sure. They're very short, weren't they? Don't know how the beds would have been lined up, maybe. Don't really know. This is all original stone. You can smell the damp. Feel it. Feel the old ones, the ancients. Right, over and over now.